This episode of Against the Odds is brought to you by Card Kingdom. To pick up the deck and support the show, follow the link in the description box down below. Hello everyone, it's Seth, probably better known as Saffron Olive, and it's time for another edition of Against the Odds. So last week, on our Against the Odds poll, we had a bunch of Dominaria options, but with a bit of a twist. Instead of Standard, this week, we are playing a Dominaria card in Modern, and in the end, we had a super clear winner on our poll. It was Traxos, Scourge of Kroog. So this week, we are heading to Modern to see if we can not necessarily beat down with Traxos, but combo off with Traxos. This is Traxos combo for Modern. So the idea is pretty sweet. It takes a bunch of pieces to actually assemble the combo, but the good news is most of our pieces have redundant extra cards that can fill in for them. So we actually have a pretty reasonable shot of finding all of our pieces. Whether or not it'll actually all come together, that remains to be seen. But a quick reminder before we break down Traxos combo for Modern. If you enjoy this deck and you enjoy Against Odds in general, it would be amazing of you if you could take a second, click that subscribe button down at the bottom of your screen. It's a great way to support the channel and the site for free. So let's talk Traxos combo, starting with Traxos Scourge of Kroog itself. So Traxos is really big and undercosted. For 4 mana, you get a 7/7 with trample. Unfortunately, it enters tapped, but it has a sweet ability where you can untap it whenever you cast a historic spell. And that's actually the main idea of our deck. So in theory, you could build like Traxos Stompy, but there's so many powerful creatures in the Modern format, it seems a little bit of a stretch. I mean, a 7/7, that's nice, but it still dies to a lot of Modern removal. You gotta really build around it. So instead of beating down, although beating down is definitely our backup plan, our idea is to go infinite with Traxos and hopefully use it to kill our opponent. So how do we go infinite with Traxos? Let's walk through step by step, but first, gotta mention Battered Golem. So the part of Traxos that we are trying to abuse is the fact that whenever we cast a historic spell, we get to untap it. So that's what allows us to go infinite. Battered Golem basically gives us a backup Traxos in that sense. So it doesn't untap. However, whenever an artifact comes into play, and artifacts are historic, then we get to untap it. So Battered Golem can substitute for Traxos as our combo piece. Which one is better? It's kind of a toss-up. So Battered Golem, 1 mana cheaper, which is nice. That means in theory we can combo off a turn quicker. However, Traxos is a 7/7, so it's not dying to lightning bolts and some of the other removal spells in the format. So kind of a bit of give and take there, but regardless, this means we have 6 Traxoses in our deck and increases odds that we will have one as many games as possible. So step 1 to the combo, Traxos or Battered Golem. Step 2 is we need a 0 mana artifact. So Mox Opal, Mishra Bauble are our main 0 mana artifacts. Opal is nice because it also ramps us into Traxos. We have a bunch of artifacts in the deck. It adds an extra mana, so we can play Traxos a turn earlier. Bauble has the upside that if we're digging for combo pieces, we can always sack it and draw a card. And then once we have our combo, it can fill the 0 mana artifact role and allow us to combo off. So we find Traxos, we find a 0 mana artifact. The next step is Banishing Knack or Retraction Helix. And this is where you can kind of see the loop of the deck. So if we have a Traxos, and we have a Mox Opal, and we have either Banishing Knack or Retraction Helix, which are literally the same exact card, all we need to do is target Traxos with the Banishing Knack or Retraction Helix, and then we have a Traxos that can tap to bounce a non-land permanent. So what we do is we bounce the Mox Opal, then we pick up the Mox Opal, we replay the Mox Opal, which untaps Traxos, so we tap it to bounce the Mox Opal, pick up Mox Opal, replay Mox Opal, untap Traxos, again and again and again and again. We can do this an infinite number of times, and then the last piece of our combo is Altar of the Brood. So if we go through that loop that we were just talking about with an Altar of the Brood on the battlefield, we just mill our opponent out of the game. Whenever a permanent enters the battlefield under our control, we mill each opponent for 1 card. So as we are bouncing and replaying Mox Opal, we're milling 1 card every time we do that, and eventually opponent just runs out of cards and they go to their next turn, they draw a card, they lose the game to drawing on an empty library. So that is the main combo of Traxos combo. That's what we're trying to set up. The rest of the deck is dedicated to finding the combo and protecting the combo. So for finding the combo, we got a few different options. Riddlesmith just allows us to loot as we were playing artifacts. So the upside of Riddlesmith is that we can play it on turn 2, play random Baubles and Mox Opals, Traxoses, and loot for combo pieces. And then, as we are comboing off, we're able to basically just loot through our entire deck. We don't actually end up with a million cards in hand, but we get to loot through our entire deck to find our combo pieces, which means if we don't have Ultra the Brood, but we have Riddlesmith, we just go through the loop, replay Mox Opal again and again and again, loot until we find the Mox Opal. And I didn't mention this because it's not really relevant to our deck, but technically we're making infinite mana as well, because we can tap the Mox Opal in between bouncing it. So then we're able to make infinite mana, we use the mana, we cast the Ultra of the Brood that we find with the Riddlesmith, then we proceed to mill our opponent out. Otherwise, Serum Visions, turn one, sets things up, digs for combo pieces, thirst for knowledge, just draws three, discards two, pretty powerful, War of Invention, tutors up an artifact, and then for protection, we have two Swan Songs, which counters basically anything that our opponent could throw at our Traxos, and then a Padim Console of Innovation, maybe draws us some cards, mostly there to give our Traxoses and Mox Opals hexproof. Blue Sun Zenith is the one card that takes advantage of our infinite mana, so one of the problems with our main deck is if we run into an Emrakul deck, we're going to have a really hard time winning, because our opponent can just keep milling and milling the Emrakul, shuffling their graveyard back in. If we can maybe draw through our deck with Riddlesmith, we're making infinite mana with Mox Opal. Instead of trying to mill our opponent out, we can just force our opponent to draw more than their entire deck at once with Blue Sun Zenith, and that wins even through an Emrakul, because our opponent has no chance to discard and shuffle back in or anything like that. So this is our kind of one card shout out to trying to beat Emrakul decks. Thankfully, Emrakul decks aren't extremely popular. There are a few, but it's nice to have the option anyway. Plus, we can always just draw a bunch of cards with it. If we make a bunch of mana, even drawing three or four cards helps us find our combo pieces. In the mana base, Darkseal Citadel to turn on Mox Opal primarily, Inventor's Fair, more Artifact Tutoring, Ghost Quarter, just for protection against creature lands, Tron lands, Search for Iskanta, Islands to cast our stuff. In the sideboard, Relic and Surgical Extraction are for that Emrakul problem we were talking about. Gives us ways to exile the graveyard, exile the Emrakul when it gets milled into the graveyard, before it shuffles back in, proceed to continue comboing off. Surgical's the best at that because we just get rid of the Emrakuls forever and then keep comboing, keep milling, and we'll win the game. Relic, though, can work in a pinch, plus it's good in other matchups. Otherwise, way more counters to protect our combo. Swan Songs, more of them, Disdainful Stroke, Negates. Then we have Spreading Seas, just as kind of a catch-all answer to decks like Tron, plus it cycles, so it's never bad. And that is Traxos Combo for Modern, and that is our Against the Odds deck for this week. So, is this gonna work? Eventually, I hope. We do need a lot of combo pieces. We do have a lot of ways to find our combo pieces. How consistently we could set up this combo, that remains to be seen, but I think there's a chance that we will pull it off at least some percentage of the time. Plus, if everything goes wrong, we can still just beat down with a 7-7, and maybe that'll be good enough in some matchup. So anyway, let's get to the video so you can see how Traxos combo works. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will talk to you soon. Alright, Against the Odds time, playing some Traxos combo, and this hand's actually pretty good. All we need is a zero mana artifact, and we're ready to try to combo, and we even have Thirst for Knowledge to dig for it. Well, let's play Altar of the Brood. Go. Opponent, Mountain, and it looks like Burn. Let's see if we're fast enough. Opponent gets in with Swift Spear, down to 19, and passes. We'll play an island. Yeah, I guess we mill our opponent. Pass the turn. So we can Thirst next turn into Traxos the following turn. Good news is our opponent should not be able to kill Traxos. And then if we hit a zero mana artifact, we should be able to just win. Opponent. Boros Charm. Pump Swift Spear. Down to 15. Swift Spear down to 13. Opponent passes. Well, play Inventor's Fair. Mill our opponent. Well, we can discard a Traxos to this Thirst, so it's not that bad. Mill to Boros Charm, pass the turn. Traxos will be summoning sick. Boros Charm. Well, that's Thirst for Knowledge. Discard an artifact. Opponent, getting it. Yep. Come on, Mox Opal, please. Being able to block here would really help. Swan Song. I'll play Darksteel Citadel. There's a pretty good chance we're dead here with our opponent not making land drops, but we're going to play Traxos. Pass the turn. If we could have hit an artifact, we could have untapped it. Well, let's see. We're dead to two bolts. Yeah, we're almost certainly dead. Lightning Bolt for our opponent. And a Targus Command. All right. Not quite fast enough. All right, we're on the play. Okay. Little light on combo pieces, but Riddlesmith helps. Island, goo. Opponent, Bloodstained Mire. Racks it. Gets a mountain. And there's a Goblin Guide. All right, here comes the damage. Opponent gets in for two. Mm-hmm. Well, we get a land. Opponent passes. Well, Island and Riddlesmith pass the turn. Opponent goes attacking. Yep. Well, another land. Yeah, let's take it. Down to 16. Wooded Foothills. Apply Inventor's Fair. Thirst. Discard Darksteel Citadel. Pass the turn. Opponent cracks. Sacred Foundry. Untapped. And Boros Charm. Well, discard an island. Oh, I don't know. Down to 12. Opponent goes attacking. More Traxos. Well, we got a block. Stay at 12. Boros Charm down to 8. Okay. Riftbolt suspended. We're probably dead next turn. There's a Traxos. Well, play Traxos. Yeah, I think we're just going to be a smidge too slow. Pass the turn. So we're dropping to 5, which means we're dead to basically any two burn spells. Down to 5. Down to 2 from Lightning Helix. And dead. All right. All right, against the odds time, playing some Traxos combo in Modern. We'll keep this. I mean, we got a Serum Visions, which is good enough. Good enough to keep. Cinderglade for our opponent. And passes. Well, Island, Serum Visions. So, Titan Shift, most likely. Oh, Bobble Bottom, Opal. I think we'll keep Opal. Pass the turn. Opponent, Secure Tribe Elder. Yep. And passes. So, let's Serum Visions. Ooh, Riddlesmith is kind of sweet. We don't need Retraction Helix. We will keep War of Invention. Play Darksteel Citadel, pass the turn. Opponent cracks, gets a land. I mean, if our opponent can just Titan, it's going to be hard to win through that mountain for our opponent. Surge Suspended, Secure Drive Elder. Yeah, opponent passes. All right, play Riddlesmith. Play Mox Opal, loot. Face? Okay, interesting. Well, let's loot. Discard Darksteel Citadel. Mishra's Bauble, loot. Discard Banishing Knack. Play the Ghost Quarter. Pass the turn. Bonus Axe. Well, let's see if we're dead. They only have one card in hand. If that card's not Titan, I guess they need Titan and they need to draw land. Maybe? Maybe we're living? All right, kills Riddlesmith. Okay. Opponent passes. Ooh, there's the Altar of the Brood too. Well, play Altar of the Brood. Play the island. Mill our opponent. Pass the turn. I think we might have this. I mean, unless we're literally dead. Like, I think we beat a Primeval Titan. We're going to have to go Battered Golem because we don't have enough mana to get Traxos. So a Lightning Bolt would still beat us, but we have the whole combo set up. Come on, Titan. Woo! Game! Traxos! Traxos Gabo! We are actually going to race... We're actually going to raise this deck against all odds. Yeah, land Valakut. Well, that's fine because end of turn were X3. Oh, we did it. Get a Battered Golem. Mill. Sure. Untap. Banishing Knack. I mean, we have infinite mana too, but we don't really need it. Bounce Mox Opal. Cast Mox Opal. Mill our opponent. Untap. Battered Golem. And do it again. And that's game, boys and girls. Traxos combo. No Traxos this time, but still. This is exactly how we were hoping this would work. I mean, we're going to have to do this for a long time, but it is gonna work. Mill our opponent, untap. Opal, mill our opponent, untap. It would be kind of sweeter if we were doing it with Traxos, but this is still pretty sweet. Mill our opponent, untap. I guess our opponent's letting us play out the combo. I can't imagine they have anything that stops this at this point. Keep going. Keep casting. Well, that went pretty well. Turn five kill. Traxos combo. Okay. That was pretty excellent. So let's bring in our Disdainful Stroke. Bring in... Might want the Spreading Seas. I guess that's the big question. Definitely want Disdainful Stroke. I guess for Riddlesmith. Let's bring in the Spreading Seas. Go down the Swan Songs. And let's go down Blue Sun Zenith. Try it like that. All right, we'll keep this. Only one land, but we got Acer and Vision to set things up. Four is for our opponent. We'll play an island, play Acer and Visions. We don't need the second altar, but we'll keep spreading seas. Pass the turn. We can always crack this bobble if we have to. Secure Tribe Elder. Yeah, opponent passes. We'll play Darksteel Citadel. I guess we should have played Altar first. Play Altar of the Brood. Yeah, I definitely should have played Altar first. Mishra's Bobble. Mill a Roast. Interesting. Opponent cracks. Gets Mountain number 2. Verdant Catacombs. And there's a Rexage. Well, there goes Altar. All right. Crack Bobble. Ooh, opponent's going to draw Blood Braid. They might crack their Fetch, though. Opponent passes. We draw 2. Ugh. Well, now I guess we need to... Spreading Seas? That did get our opponent to shuffle away the Blood Braid. The deck doesn't play that many green sources. Oh, no. Pass the turn. Not fighting this land. Maybe we should have went Mountain to try to cut off Valakut triggers in the future, but green tries to cut off Titan. It's a tough one. Tireless Tracker. All right. Opponent's got the mana anyway. Cinderglade. Yeah, probably should have went Mountain. Cracks the clue. Draws a card. Gets in 4-2. Yep. Down to 18. Oh, dear. Play Altar of the Brood. Well, I guess we probably weren't going to win this one no matter what we did. Play Altar of the Brood. Just don't have enough lands. Mill our opponent. Pass the turn. Valakut gets a clue. Cracks a clue. Yeah, this one might be over. Secure Tribe Elder. Opponent gets in. Well, I think we're just going to get beaten down. No combo necessary for our opponent. Passes. Yeah. Play Citadel. Oh. Ancient Grudge milled. All right. Yeah, now we're dead. I was going to say we could just Batter Golem combo, but our opponent with the Ancient Grudge and a million roasts. Huh. Let's go down the Riddlesmith up the Swan Song. Try it like that. All right, we're on the play. Okay, I guess. We got creatures. All right. Darksteel Citadel, go. We're not that far away from comboing. Opponent, Ancient Grudge is pretty good against us. Well, Citadel, Mox Opal, Battered Golem. Pass the turn. What do you got, opponent? Wooded Foothills and Lightning Bolt. All right. Well, thankfully, we still have Traxos. Inventor's Fair. Play Traxos. Please, no Ancient Grudge. Pass the turn. Opponent cracks. Forest. Stomping Grounds. Untapped. And there's a Tracker. Yup. And let's see what we draw. We do gain a life. 1, 2, 3... Yeah, play Mox Opal, untap, keep the new Mox Opal, sack Inventor's Fair. I guess we just take Altar of the Brood, play Inventor's Fair, get in with Traxos, hit our opponent. Man, are we going to get, is it possible we just get the Traxos beatdown win? Altar of the Brood, go. Opponent, no attacks. Catacombs gets a clue. Sucker Tribe Elder. And passes. All right, gain a life, more Traxos. Well, get in with Traxos. Hit our opponent. Blocks and blocks. They must have Lightning Bolt. Yep, hit our opponent for 4. I'm so tempted to just play this Traxos. Our opponent definitely has Lightning Bolt. So as weird as this sounds, there's no way they wouldn't sack the Sakura Tribe Elder. As weird as this sounds, we are just going to play a fresh Traxos. Oh, well, that works. Traxos is legendary, so that's a freebie. No mill grudge. All right, Secure Tribe Elder, pass the turn. All right, maybe? Tracker, ugh. Sax gets a clue. Forest. Oh, they do have a land, so they can go to 1? Sax a clue. Oh, wow. Come on, top deck. If we hit a Banishing Knack, we combo kill. Opponent passes. Gain a life. Come on. Island. Well, Sax Inventor's Fair. Get a bobble. Play the bobble. Untap. Mill our opponent. Hit our opponent to 1. This is not the plan. Play the island. Oh, I'm scared to play that. All right, pass the turn. Oh, man. Oh, man. We kill through a Titan here. A Titan blocking. Land. Sags a clue. Sags a clue. And scoops it up. Oh, we got there. Traxos comboing off in modern. Whoo. We got the combo kill and the beatdown kill. That was pretty sweet. That was super sweet. All right, against the odds time, playing some Traxos combo in modern, and no Traxos, but we got a bunch of redraws. So Island, Bobble, take a peek at what our opponent's playing. Liliana. All right. So Jund, most likely. Opponent. Tap land. Second Opal. Mishra's Bauble. Mox Opal. Pass the turn. So now we're mostly looking for Traxos and ways to find Traxos. Also, ways to stop removal wouldn't be bad. All right, let's crack Bauble. Opponent's drawing a Bolt. This does turn off Opal. Serum Visions. There's Altar of the Brood. Island bottom, Serum Visions top. Play Altar. Play Bauble. Mill. Play Island. Mill. Pass the turn. Dark Confidant, Bloodbraid Elf. Well, that's some damage. Black Cleave Cliffs for our opponent. Gets in with Bob. Yep. Down to 18. There's Liliana. Okay. That's going to be hard to combo off through. Well, discard Banishing Knack. Crack Bauble. Opponent has a land on top. Well, that's Serum Visions. Put on top. Put on top. Thirst for Knowledge. Discard Opal, play the land. This Liliana is going to be really hard for us to beat here. Opponent, and Coligan's Command. Yeah, these are the hard matchups. Like, we have our combo set up if we were in a more goldfishy matchup, but Jund has so many ways to kill Traxos. Ticks up. Well, I guess we discard Swansong? Yep. Opponent discards Bitter Blossom. And here comes Bloodbraid Elf. Yep. Ugh. And Abrupt Decay. Yeah, this one feels pretty in the books. Down to 13. Yeah. Opponent passes. Apply Traxos. Pass the turn. Liliana can just tick down and kill it, though. Or they can Coligan's Command it. Dark Confidant. I guess we can hope Bob somehow kills our opponent. Treetop Village. Ticks up. We'll discard Island. Opponent gets in. Down to 8. And, yeah. Alright, that does it. Oh, boy. Yeah, Jund feels like a rough one. So we can bring in Negates. Go down... Blue Sun Zenith. Go down... I guess one Riddlesmith. And, actually, let's cut one of our Retraction Helixes. Try it like that. All right, we are on the play. Well, this hand's not good, but we have lots of ways to improve it. So let's Serum Visions. Well, yeah, I guess we got to keep both of these. Bauble gives us something to discard to Thirst if we need to. And we do need Banishing Knack for the combo. Raging Ravine. And passes. I'll play an Island. All right, let's play Bauble. Pass the turn. Opponent, Black Cleave Cliffs. Come on, no Bob. Please, no Bob. All right, Tarmogoyf. Well, crack Bauble. Tracker on top. So we draw. Ooh, Padim. Well, let's pass. Battered Golem seems better post-Padim. Opponent gets in. 4-2. Bolts to pump. All right, gets in for 3. Down to 14. Well, let's Thirst. Discard Citadel. Untap. Play an Island. Oh man, this Goyf. We grow the Goyf. All these thirsts are making this Goyf huge. Padim, go. Opponent. Terminates Padim. Ooh, I don't know. Jund might just be like a really hard matchup. Gets in with Goyf. Down to 9. Well, there's Swansong. Play Battered Golem. Pass the turn. Opponent. Coligan's Command. Well, let's Swansong. Opponent gets a bird. Land. Oh, they just have so much removal. Cracks Wooded Foothills. Forest. Ancient Grudge. All right. Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah, this is a... We're better off trying to race the goldfish decks, not power through control. I don't think there's a way we stop this Goyf now. Down to 4. Traxos comes into play tapped. Yeah, that does it. All right. Against the odds time, playing some... Ooh. Traxos combo, and we have the fast mana hand. So Bauble, unfortunately we're not able to loot along the way, but we get a turn 1 Riddlesmith. Pass the turn. Breeding Pool. Untapped. And Mausoleum Wanderer. Alright, so I guess we can hit more free artifacts to loot. Well, let's see what's on top of our deck. So we draw an Island off Bauble. And Retraction Helix. We'll play the Island. Pass the turn. Now I wish we hand cracked the Bauble. Opponent. Razor Verge Thicket. Selfless Spirit. All right. Pumps Wanderer. Gets in. 4-2. Well, now I guess we crack the second bobble. Opponent's drawing Breeding Pool. We draw two. Ugh. This isn't the most ideal. Play Riddlesmith. Get in with Riddlesmith. Opponent's gonna trade. Interesting. All right, pass the turn. Definitely need some lands. We're not far away from comboing. Breeding Pool. Untapped. Drog Skull Captain. Yep. Opponent gets in. 4-3. Down to 15. And passes. Well, let's Serum Visions. Thirst to the bottom. Land to the top. Play the land. Get in with Riddlesmith. Wow, opponent really wants to kill Riddlesmiths. Pass the turn. Tap land for our opponent. More Drog Skull Captains. All right. Opponent gets in. Down to 12. Well, draw the island. Play Traxos. Pass the turn. This Mausoleum Wanderer is an issue. Otherwise, we're pretty close to comboing. Planes for our opponent. Oh, Collective Company? Yup. Well, let's see what they find. Geist of St. Traft, Selfless Spirit. So I think we need to just naturally draw these Mausoleum Wanderers. Opponent gets in. We're not going to be able to resolve Retraction Helix, are we? Traxos. Thirst for Knowledge? Yeah, opponent sacks, and that does it. That was close. Those Mausoleum Wanderers were extremely obnoxious. All right, run it back. All right, we get to play first. Oh, this hand has everything except the lands. I guess we get to redraw with Bobble. All right, we'll try this. So Darksteel Citadel, Alter the Brood, Mishra's Bobble. Mill our opponent, pass the turn. Opponent cracks it. And Noble Hierarch. Well, let's crack Bobble. Opponent's drawing Drog Skull Captain. We draw two. Oh dear. That's the nightmare. No land. No land. Oh boy. Well, now this is probably going poorly. Windswept Teeth. Opponent passes. Oh, play Mox Opal. The problem is they have Bellqueller. Yep. Ooh, opponent lets it go. Okay. That's good. Mill Selfless Spirit. Play Serum Visions. Opal bottom, island top. All right, we're kind of trying to piece it together. Cracks Windswept Teeth. Gets a Hallowed Fountain. And Rattle Chains. Yep. And Mausoleum Wander. Oh dear. Botanical Sanctum. Aye. Oh my goodness. So many Mausoleum Wanders. And they still have Spellqueller. Oh boy. Opponent gets in. Yep. Down to 16. And passes. Well, play the island. Mill our opponent. Pass the turn, I guess. It's just, we're too slow. They get to flash in the Lord. Yep. And that makes all their things just so big. Opponent gets in for a bunch. I guess we should cast Thirst now. So if our opponent wants to counter, they have to sack. Ugh, there's a Spellqueller. Yeah, this isn't gonna work. Yep, gets rid of Thirst. Well, let's, yeah. We're dead. Whew! So many spirits. Well, not that time. All right, against the odds time, playing some Traxos combo in Modern. And, Merfolk. Okay. Well, land Mox Opal. Pass the turn. Mutavault for our opponent. And Silvergill. Opponent gets in. 4-1. Down to 19. We'll play Citadel. Play Bobble. So we get to Traxos next turn, but we still need more combo pieces to really go off. And these Swan Songs aren't looking great against Merfolk. Silvergill Adept for our opponent. Opponent gets in. Yeah, let's crack Bobble. Oh man, that Harbinger. The natural enemy of Traxos. I'll play an island, play Traxos. Oh boy. It's feeding itself right into that Harbinger though. Harbinger Tides. Yep. Bounces Traxos. Fires up Mutavault. Gets in for a bunch. And yeah, I think we're just dead. Well, play an island. Play Traxos. If they fire up Mutavault, we're just dead. Or Lord of Atlantis. That also achieves the same ends. All right. Against Merfolk, we're just goldfishing. Run it back. Run it back. We just got a race. All right. We get to play first. Okay, we got Traxos. We have Serum Visions to set things up. We don't want Whirr. We do need Island. Pass the turn. All right, we'll see. We'll see. Harbinger of Tides. That is a natural Traxos hoser. There's Aether Vial. Opponent passes. Well, play Citadel. Run out our Riddlesmith. And pass the turn. Opponent. Aboru. Opponent passes. Well, play Altar of the Brood. Loot. Discard Banishing Knack. Play Darksteel Citadel. Mill our opponent past the turn. Opponent. Curse Catcher. Trickster. Taps down Riddlesmith. Okay. Vile. Taking up to two. Mute Vault. So we need to find a Mox Opal or a Zerman artifact. Spreading Seas is fine. Yep. Opponent. Gets in. No Lord? There's a Lord. All right. Yep. Down to 15. And Curse Catcher. Well, play the Island. Mill our opponent. Play Traxos. Loot. Come on, Mox Opal. Also, no Alter the Brood. We don't need Alter the Brood. Mill our opponent. All right, pass the turn. Can we survive one more turn? Maybe. Opponent. Mute Vault. Gets in, gets in, gets in, gets in. Well, we got a shot. We got to draw this turn, and it's got to resolve. No, not Harbinger. Oh, now we don't have a shot. Oh, man. Harbinger's so good. Yeah, now we're just straight up dead. Ugh. Well, we learned something. Harbinger of Tides. Good against Traxos. Yikes. All right, all right, all right, all right. Whew. All right, against the odds time, we are playing some Traxos combo in Modern. And we'll try this. I mean, we get to start milling. We're missing some combo pieces, but we do have Thirst to dig for them. Island for our opponent. I'll play an Island. Mill our opponent. Pass the turn. Through the Breach almost certainly means Emrakul. Emrakul almost certainly means can't win. Loot House for our opponent. Spirit Guide. Wow! Okay. Three Spirit Guides through the Breach. Well, hopefully we draw some lands. Our opponent, actually, let's just scoop. So we gotta bring in all of our Graveyard Hate stuff. Relic, 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 Relic. Probably Surgicals as well. Go down the Swan Songs, I think. Go down one Riddlesmith. Go down Blue Sun Zenith. Go down one Retraction Helix. And I guess one Thirst for Knowledge. Let's leave the Thirst and just go three Relics. Try it like that. All right, we get to play first. And all right, we'll give this a shot. Island, Bobble, Goo. Island for our opponent. Well, let's crack Bobble. Churn through our deck a bit. All right, we get to draw a card. Well, play the Island. Play Altar of the Brood. Play Relic of Progenitus. Mill our opponent. And exile. Pass the turn. Opponent ops. Yep. Misty Rainforest. We are going to need to find a land. Stomping Grounds. Untap. Yeah. Well, there goes Relic. Well, come on, land! Come on, land! Alright, Serum Visions. Bottom, bottom. Pass the turn. Yikes. Yikes, yikes, yikes. Turn to Emrakul and then stuck on lands. Serum Visions for our opponents. And there's an Ancient Grudge. Yep. Steam Vents. Tapped. We have a lot of our combo pieces. Land, please. Alright, there's a land. So let's Thirst. Discard Traxos. Man, we have the combo. If we get annihilated by Emrakul, it's not going to matter, but it's going to take us two turns and our opponent not countering our stuff. Opponent ops. And Sebion. Opponent passes. I'll play an Island. Play Traxos. See if we're not dead? Come on. Come on. Nothing, nothing, nothing. Just tap out for some cantrips or something. Opponent, are we dead? Loots? Okay. Discards. And passes. All right, I think we got it. So we play Mox Opal. Actually, we don't really have it. Just kidding about the having it part. Get in with Traxos. Play Altar of the Brood. Play Relic of Progenitus. Mill our opponent. Play Ghost Quarter. Mill our opponent. Ghost Quarter the Loot House. And pass the turn. Opponent plays a land through the Breach. All right. We actually have an answer to Emrakul. Retraction Helix. Bounce Emrakul. So we're not dead, but we still can't combo off, unfortunately. And we have a tap Traxos. All right. Let's see what we draw. Riddlesmith. So crack Relic. We really need an artifact. All right. Play Riddlesmith. Mill our opponent. Play Mox Opal. Untap and loot. All right, in theory, we have the Traxos skill for next turn. I mean, this isn't the plan. This isn't how we're trying to do this, but it's kind of maybe working. Ops to the bottom. Untaps. Cycles Sweltering Suns. And scoops it up. We got there. Traxos beatdown. The bouncing of Emrakul. One of the only ways to deal with the instant speed Emrakul. And we pulled it off. Maybe we got to go down a relic. We probably need some counters. We can probably go down Padim. Two relics, two surgicals. Yeah, let's go two swan songs. Try it like that. Okay. This hand's got a lot of action. Don't mind it. We'll keep island for our opponent and certain visions. Opponent passing. Well, let's island Bobble, Opal, Relic, Serum Visions, bottom and top. We'll keep one. Might as well exile Serum Visions and pass the turn. Flooded Strand for our opponent. And passes. Okay. A play in Venner's Fair. Pass the turn. We're not super far away from comboing. We don't have any real defense. Opponent ops. All right, let's use this window to thirst. Oh, one mana counter. Steam Vents. Okay, tapped. Now, discard relic. Pass the turn. We still need a surgical. That's our main. Opponents passing. All right, exile a land, gain some life. Another Mox Opal. Let's Serum Visions. So Opal bottom. I guess we don't have a finisher yet either. Bobble bottom. Play the island, pass the turn. Opponent. Tapping, untapping, untaps. Ooh, no land. All right. Wouldn't mind one of our swan songs or something. Ooh, Altar of the Brood. Well, play Altar. Play Ghost Quarter. Mill our opponent. Exile Ancient Grudge, thank goodness. Why, our opponent doesn't have green mana. Actually, let's crack Bobble. We have enough artifacts now. Crack Bobble, see what our opponent's gonna draw. Blood Moon. Ooh, we actually like that. Ancient Grudge on Relic. All right, sack it, draw a card. This does turn off our Mox. Ooh, our Surgical. Man, we just gotta resolve our stuff. We have every combo piece. We draw an extra card. Island. Opponents passing. I'll play Altar of the Brood. Mill our opponent. Surgical your Emrakul? This might be enough by itself. The random mill value. Emrakul's down. Oh, we also get to see that the hand has no counters. Not many win cons. This also hilariously shuffles the Ancient Grudge back in. Play the island. Mill. Play Traxos. And, Ancient Grudge. Come on, no green mana. Wow. I don't know about this idea. Just runs out Snapcaster. Opponent. Odds of winning are going up. Wow, I can't believe we might be winning this. Oh, they top decked an Ancient Grudge. Okay. Well, that slows us down. And they have a million grudges in the graveyard. We gain a life. Play the island. Mill our opponent. Sack Inventor's Fair. Yeah, let's just take Traxos. We really need our opponent to not draw a fetch land. Now we're just going to get Grudge. Now we need to find a relic, I guess. Opponent gets it. Yeah, down to 17. Oh, play another Altar of the Brood. Mill our opponent. Play Traxos. Mill our opponent. Yeah, let's just pass. Yep, Traxos down. Opponent. All right, going after a Altar of the Brood. Serum Visions. Well, that's a lot of Ancient Grudges down. Opponent gets in. Mm-hmm. Down to 15. Oh, dear. Well, Ghost Quarter the Loot House. Pass the turn. We're kind of Banishing Knack flooded. Island for our opponent. Gets in with Snapcaster. Yep, down to 13. I'll play an island. Pass the turn. I don't think our natural mill plan is going to be fast enough. Goes attacking. Down to 11. Passes. Play an island. Mill our opponent. Down to 20 cards. Oh, man. We're just going to get beat down by Snapcaster. Opponent gets in. Yep. Down to 9. Passes. Oh, play Bobble. Mill our opponent. Crack Bobble. Opponent's drawing another loot house. Uh-oh. Is this cryptic? Bounces an altar. All right. We get to draw. There's the loot house. Opponent gets in with Snapcaster. Uh-huh. Oh, do they have more cryptics? They're not in the graveyard. Oh, play Altar of the Brood. There's a cryptic. Play Traxos. Mill our opponent for one. Pass the turn. Land. Opponent goes attacking. Yep. Down to five. Passes. Well, let's thirst. Discard two cards. Serum Visions and Banishing Knack. Play Mox Opal. Untap Traxos. Yep. Keep the new Mox Opal. Mill our opponent for one. Retraction Helix. Resolves. All right, tap for a mana. Or bounce Mox Opal. Do we do it? Replay Mox Opal. Untap. Mill our opponent. Traxos? Uh-oh. Opponent loots. Okay. Discards a Blood Moon. Tap Mox Opal. Bounce Mox Opal. Replay Mox Opal. Untap. Mill. Down to eight. Might as well keep floating mana. Bounce it. Replay it. Untap it. Down to seven cards. Traxos. Traxos combo. I'm a little worried about Ancient Grudge, especially if our opponent has Dispel, but untap. Mill. Oh, there's the Grudge. So tap. Bounce. Going to try to kill Traxos. Huh. All right. Bounce Mox Opal. Play Darksteel Citadel. Down to five. Down to four. Oh, man. Are we going to lose this race by, like, one card? Pass the turn. Opponent untaps. Three cards. Plays a land. Goes attacking. Down to three. Passes. Play Darksteel Citadel. Down to two cards. Play Mox Opal. Did we get it? Resolves. Keep the new one. Mill our opponent. Down to one card. Pass the turn. Untaps. Come on, no bolts. Zero cards in the library. Oh no. Is this... If we die to a Simian Spirit Guide off through the breach. Okay. No. 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 Oh no. Oh my god. All right. Oh, the last card. Wow. Well, for all the Ancient Grudges and fighting through Emrakul, which is our nightmare matchup, that was a pretty good performance for our deck. Pretty good performance. I mean, we're dead, but... Oh, what a game! What a crazy game! Good God! Woo! Oh, you got us, opponent. You got us. So why don't we learn this week about Traxos combo in Modern? And overall, at least by the record, it was kind of a rough one. So we played five matches. We won one of them. Although, oh my goodness, we should have beat that crazy breach deck. Oh, I still can't believe that we managed to lose that one. That was an insane match, though, even though we lost. So that puts us at like 20%. As far as games, we were 3 out of 14, which is also around 20%-ish. So overall, just... not that great. I do feel like we saw the good of the deck. Like, we were able to straight up race Titan Shift, and that was pretty impressive. Titan Shift is a fast deck, and we were able to just out goldfish them. So you can see the power of the deck when things come together. On the other hand, against all the aggro decks, which was kind of our big bugaboo, Spirits, also Burn, also Merfolk, we just had a hard time keeping pace with our opponent just pressure, pressure, Lord, Lord, burn, burn. And we were just not fast enough. Even when we were close, we just weren't quite fast enough to combo off. So I felt like the deck did a good job of doing what we set out to do. Like, it did get the combo pieces consistently. We were able to assemble the combo and pull it off, but it's just a little slower than I would like, especially when you consider the number of pieces we need. Even with the redundancy, we're looking at comboing off normally like turn 5-ish because Traxos or Battered Golem has to be not summoning sick, and Modern is kind of a turn 4-ish format, and that's what we saw with a lot of the aggro decks, where it felt like, okay, maybe we can do this, but then one removal spell or one counter spell would be enough to keep our combo at bay and allow our opponent to win the game. So I think the combo is sweet, and it was really cool to see it go off. And again, the Breach game, even though we lost, that was just one of the better and crazier games of Magic we played in a long, long time. So I had fun with the deck, but as far as winning tournaments with Traxos, I think it's just a little bit too combo heavy. You need too many combo pieces and too many things to go right to actually win. So I don't know if it's really a competitive deck, but it is a sweet deck, and it was cool to see Traxos actually combo off and go infinite in Modern. So anyway, that's been our Against the Odds for this week. Traxos combo for Modern. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will talk to you soon.
Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, help us out by clicking that like button down below. And to keep up on all the latest and greatest, click that subscribe button. And don't forget to hit that bell icon to get alerts whenever we have new videos. And if you want to, check out some of our other sweet videos here and here.